Hi everyone, Bill McMillan here again. Right now we're going to go ahead and I'm going to show you how I make ground goop. Remember I talked about that in the other videos, and I use it as a base on the layout so I can then put on the ground cover and especially the static grass and weeds and bushes and things like that. So in other words, this is the dirt. Now, ground goop consists of four primary ingredients. First of those ingredients is something called cellulay. You go ahead and pick this up at hobby shops and some of the craft stores like Michael's and Hobby Lobby. Then we're going to need some brown latex paint. Now I picked this up at Home Depot from their mistakes shelf. You know, don't spend a lot of money for this stuff. We're just using it as an adhesive and a coloring agent. So you look around, chances are you'll find somebody that wanted a brown that didn't like this shade. Third component is Elmer's white glue. Now I know in some of my other videos, especially in the scenery, when we're doing static grass, I told you I don't like school glue. Well, for this purpose, it'll work just fine. We're just mixing this up with the latex and everything. So the other benefit is you can usually pick this stuff up pretty cheap, especially before school starts in the fall, like around late July, early August. I got this at Target for $1.19 a gallon. The fourth ingredient is called vermiculite, and this is normally used for gardening. It adds a nice texture and more bulk to the ground goop mixture. And you can see it, it's in something of a powdery type form, but doesn't have much dust, so you don't have to really worry about that. Now, you're going to need some tools. Oh, one thing before I forget. I do add another ingredient, Clorox toilet bowl cleaner. Yeah, I know. Sounds weird, but believe me, you want to use this. We're not going to use a lot. It contains bleach and also a soap. The bleach will inhibit mold from growing during the dry process. It also has, like I said, a dishwash type of material, so it'll help all the liquids kind of flow out a little bit better. I have just used a little bit of bleach, so if you just have some of that laying around, that should work just fine. Now the tools. You need a mixing bowl. This is a Rubbermaid salad bowl. Comes with a cover. And you're going to want to find something with a cover, because if you don't use up all the material in one time, you can go ahead and put a tight cover on it and it'll last for days, if not weeks. It takes a long time for this stuff to dry. Also, you're going to need some mixing paddles. These, of course, are paint sticks. You're going to need a measuring cup. Now, I just use throwaway, these are 8-ounce or 10-ounce plastic cups. And believe me, throwaway, cheapest is best. Save your cups when you go to McDonald's or whatever, because once you get this thing dipped into the latex paint, full of glue, you're not going to want to try and clean these out. Finally, to spread the material out onto the layout surface, I use a lot of various sizes of putty knives, small trowels, even down to this size to get into tight corners, especially around track edges and buildings that you may have put onto your layout. So just pick up what's available. Don't have any? Go to a garage sale. I'm sure you'll find some of this stuff. Okay. Well, we'll get started and show you how we mix this stuff up. Well, let's get started. Now the formula for this is pretty simple. Remember I said there were four primary components. Well, what we're going to use is one measure of each. The only one you're going to want to maybe use a little bit less than a full cup is the glue. 2/3 to 3/4 works just fine. And if you just use the same measurement, you probably won't run into any problems. I'll show you later on when we're mixing this stuff if it doesn't feel right to you, if the consistency is a little bit too thick, we're just going to add a little bit of water. So, start off with our bowl. We'll get us a nice full cup of vermiculite. Then we'll take and get a nice full cup of cellulite. Then I'm going to add my glue. And I'll show you why we add the glue now instead of the paint. That nice into our mixing bowl. Not going to worry about getting it all out because now I'm going to take that, dip it right into our paint, come up with a nice full glass bowl, and dump her on in. Here she is. Now what you can do is, well, you're going to get your hands dirty here, if you can. I'm going to take my mixing stick, just kind of scrape out what I've got there. I know this is messy, but that's what it's all about. Okay,
fun time.
Back again, just cleaned off the hands. Of course, it's good to have some paper towels, which I neglected to have, but it's nice to have a sink right by so you can do a quick wash up. Now, like I said, I'm just going to squirt some of this Clorox in there. Don't need a lot. That'll do just fine. And then we can start mixing. So you just keep mixing and mixing and mixing and mixing until all of the dry material is absorbed into the liquid. Now, this does become a little bit difficult because it starts getting very thick, but just persevere and just keep going. Now, as you can see, this is what it's starting to look like. You can see it's sticking together and such. And like I said, this is a little bit thicker than what I do like to use. So I will go ahead and add a little bit of water. A little bit less than a half measure, more like about a quarter of a measure. Now I can just continue to stir this stuff up.
Okay.
Now, you should end up with something like this. Almost becomes elastic. That's all the latex that's in it, you know, with the school glue and everything. So, now we're ready to go ahead and start putting this out onto the layout. Here we are, ready to put down our ground foam. As you can see, it's all mixed up and nice and sticky and gooey. Got my tools. I also have a source for water. You're going to want this for cleaning the edge of the tool, helps to smooth out areas. And of course, some paper towel or some rags. Now you'll also notice that this is a genuine flat tabletop area, and I don't really like that. So what I like to do is, I like to cut pieces. This is 1/4 inch pink foam. I like to cut those, glue them onto the tabletop so I can have some variations in the topography. Believe me, you'll like it a lot better when it comes out that way. So, let's get started putting some of this stuff down onto the surface. Let me grab some of this material, bring it out, start to smooth it out. Now you can see that sometimes it doesn't want to cooperate very much at all. If it's like that, then go ahead and remix by putting in a little bit more paint and a little bit more water. All right, I've added about a 1/2 to 3/4 measure of a cup of water, and you can see now it's a little bit more usable. Our first batch there was just a little bit too dry. So I'm going to get some of this out, trying careful not to get it onto the track and such. I'm just using my mixing stick here. I'll get a hold of the paint knives and putty knives in just a sec. Just want to get some of this stuff down so that I can spread it out and work with it. Now don't worry too much about it if you get too much on, like dripping over the track. You can just hit it with your finger, or later on we can clean it up too. Now I'll go ahead and start spreading this stuff out, mixing it with the material that I've already done. Like when you have a structure or a building like this, just be careful. Just try to get it up to the edge. Smooth it out. You can see how nice it starts to flow. It takes a little bit of work, a little bit of time. Bring it right up to the end here. Get her up to the edge of the ties and such. Don't worry about it trying to look very level. Remember, ground is always not level. These areas that aren't being covered by the ties, don't worry about that. We're going to get that with the ballast. Now the other thing that you'll find is, see these ridges here? Actually, gravity is just going to help those to settle out. But they're going to look like natural formations as far as dirt is concerned. Here's an area I just want to try and get a little bit closer to the edge of the So now you can see that we've covered that first area. I'm going to work on this area next, doing the same thing, and we'll see what that looks like. smooth this stuff out. Bring her on up to the edge and let it mix with the other material that I had already put in down. Remember to your tools, they're your friend. Like I said, you can use some water, just wet your tool up a little bit. That does help to smooth this stuff out. See? Nice and easy.
Okay.
You see we've covered this area. This depression here, I'll put some stone in it and maybe some shrubs, low bushes. That'll look nice. Now we need to finish off this area. So we'll go ahead and start getting some material out here. You can see how nicely this stuff does not stick to the plastic container, which, believe me, helps tremendously.
Okay.
Now you can see what we've got here. These are the area. This is the area that batch covered for us. Looks pretty nice. Now I did put it on a little bit thick. If you're covering a large expanse and you do want flat land, this will go so much further. You just spread it out with your spatula. Okay, we're going to let that dry up and then we'll go ahead and put on our scenery. So that's it for ground goop. So just go ahead and give it a try. I think you'll like it.